Hey peeps. So this is me, day two of social distancing. Actually, I can deal with social distancing, but I can't deal with the fact that my gym is closed and that there are no dance classes available for me to go to. So I thought that I would put something together that you can do in the comfort of your own home, in a small space if need be, because for me, if I'm not moving, I go a little bit crazy. So yeah, I thought I'd just put something together. So in this vid, I'm going to take you through a contemporary dance spinal warm-up fundamentals, yeah? So not anything hectic, basics. The way it's going to be structured is that it's going to be divided into three parts, a part A, a part B, and a part C. And I'm going to teach each part separately and take you through one or two technique pointers, and then we'll put it together at the end of the vid. Okay, so to start, you're going to start with your feet parallel, toes pointing straight forward, heels pointing straight back, and you're going to align your feet directly underneath your hip bones, yeah? From there, you're going to stack all the joints one on top of the other. Your arms are hanging nice and loose at your sides, your chest is nice and open, as well as your back, and there's energy up through the crown of your head, so you're feeling nice and tall. When we start our spinal roll or curl down, you're going to start at the top of your head, and at the same time, your knees are going to relax as we go down for 8 counts. So we go, curling down, 8 counts, 5, 6, 7, curling down, 8 counts, 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and curl, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, lift your chest and release, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you scoop for 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, curling down again, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, into your plank, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, back into your squat, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, back into your plank, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, onto your feet for 4, 2, 3, 4, and curl, 2, 3, rising up for 4, 2, 3, 4, and lower, 6, 7, 8. And that's part A. Okay, so I'm going to face sideways just so I can give you some more of the pointers as we go along. Let's go through that same phrase again. From the top, curling down over 8 counts, 5, 6, 7, curling down, 8 counts, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and curl, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, lift your chest, release, and 1, 2, 3, 4, your head comes down last, 6, 7, and 8, you scoop, dive deeper between those legs, 5, 6, lift your eye line and your chest, curl down, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, from here, when I go into my squat, it's important, or into my plank, it's important that I go into the squat position first. So from here, I drop my bum, at the same time I open my knees so my body can fall through the middle, and my head is the thing that leads me and darts me out, might have a nap here, darts me out across the floor. Okay, so let me start a little bit further back. So from here, you've just done your curl down. From here, you drop the bum, open my thighs at the same time. From there, my head leads me out, zoom, out into my plank. My hands are directly underneath my shoulders. I'm pushing back in the heels, so I'm not allowing this to happen, yeah? Pushing back through the heels, and there's a straight line from the top of my head all the way out through my heels. Energy in two directions, that way, as well as that way. From here, I go back into my squat, so I bend my knees, and I allow my body to fall through the middle. From here, I go back into my plank. From here, when I want to get onto my feet for 4 counts, I think of relaxing the back of my knees and getting my heels onto the floor as quickly as I can. So the action is 1, that's the action, 2, 3, 4. From here is uncurl, I drop my sitting bones. My head is the last thing to come up. As I get there, I push the floor away from me, and then I lower from my eyes. Okay, let's go just that section from the beginning with music. Must have some liquid tunes. Otherwise, I don't feel like moving. 6, ready, 5, 6, 7, curling down, 8 counts, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and curl. thinking at all times, you're really trying to milk all the counts. So if something ends on 8, you're really ending on the t of count 8. Huh? So try and fill out all of your counts. Okay, the next section is going to focus on side bends. Huh? So nice and simple. So a quick thing about side bends, when I turn to the side, you want to make sure, or you want to imagine, that you are in between two walls, yeah? And your body can only move in this plane when you are doing your side bend. So in other words, not there or there, but directly to the side. So we get, it's a simple sequence, yeah? So we're gonna go side, let's go to the right side first. So we're gonna go side and up, with the arm and up, with the arm and up, full circle one way, full circle the other way. And then you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Side bend up, arm and up, arm and up, circle to come up, circle to come up. Okay, but it's obviously not going to look like that. Right, so we're going to go 5, 6, side bend, no arms, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, 3, other side, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, reach through your arms and paint the ceiling and the walls, 4, and up, 2, 3, other side, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, full circle, we go side, 2, 3, 4, and center, let go of the arms here, 4, continue, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, 3, other side, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and middle, 2, 3, 4, and side, 2, 3, 4, and up, 2, 3, 4, okay, so that's it. So, a few things to keep in mind. You're anchored from your hips or from your pelvis down to the floor. So, you're not allowing any of this hulaing to happen. We're not in Hawaii quite yet. Maybe later, but not now. No? So, from here downwards, you want to imagine that this is anchored to the floor and you're only using the torso and the upper body, yeah, to move. So, from here, keep it anchored. I try not to allow that to happen. Yeah, so you're really going to feel it in the obliques, all the way into the side stretches. And if you're really doing this and reaching as far as you can, your side should actually be quite sore by tomorrow. No? You can message me tomorrow and let me know. So from here, when I go into the center as well, I'm still keeping my pelvis on axis. So from here, the center, my head is still above my pelvis. So my eye line is down at my navel. As soon as I've allowed that to happen, I've put my pelvis in a different position now, yeah? So I want my pelvis still to be on axis. So my circle is only happening in this upper plane here. I'm not allowing it to go all the way down. Okay, right, so let's do that section only with the music. So it goes side and up, arm and up, arm and up, full circle to recover, full circle to recover. And then we go on the other side. All right, let's sort out our music.
Now go back to the days of December.
Only from the side bends. 5, 6, 5, 6 side bend. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2, the other side, and 1. So you're reaching up with the top of the head. You're lengthening instead of crunching. Lengthen. 1, 2, 3, 4. Side bends. The next section we're going to work on what was it again? What did I want to do? Oh yes, monkey position and flat backs. Okay, so I'm gonna show you this from the side. So from here, you're going to go into monkey position for 8 counts. You're gonna imagine that you're sitting back into an imaginary chair. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We let go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We find our flat back and reach. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let go on 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let go on 7, 8. We go. 2, 3, 4. Arms reach forward. 2, 3. Light swing. You go forward and up. Arms go down. 6, 7, 8. Only that. Times 2. Now, okay, so when we go into our monkey position, even though we're going down, you're thinking up. So it's, you're thinking opposite to what you're doing. So your body's actually, I would say, diagonally aligned, yeah? So as I go to sit in my imaginary chair, I keep reaching through the top of my head. So there's a two-way pull happening, out through my pelvis and out through the top of my head. My arms are just nice and relaxed. So I'm not holding them, they're relaxed. From here, you want to imagine that you are a marionette, a puppet, yeah, and someone's come to cut your strings. So from here, you've got tension in the body. From here, everything just goes, pop, you let go. So somebody cuts it, you go, yeah. And the true test of whether you're actually letting go or not, if you're really letting go, there will be rebound at the bottom. Your body will rebound at the bottom. If you're not really letting go, it will be stiff. So it will look something like this. If you've gone here, and you've just gone, shoo, that means you didn't really let go. Can you see there was no rebound at the bottom? So if you're really letting go, there will be a rebound. So you'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm just fast forwarding. And I really let go. And I breathe out at the same time. There we go. From here, when I go into my flat back, I'm trying to reach out all the parts of the body. So out through the arms, out through the head, out through the pelvis, yeah? It's like a four-way pull in all directions. So I'm really taking up space. You want your body to be as big as possible. So you reach, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm really reaching out this way and out that way. From here, they cut my puppet strings again and I let go. Only for 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, I let go for 2. Then I come up for 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I keep reaching. This time I reach forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, reach. From here I swing forward as I breathe out, swing, I recover, and from there I just let my arms come down. Okay, so let's try that section with the music. So it goes, monkey 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, let go, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, flat back 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, let go, and flat back 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, let go, and flat back 2, 3, 4, onto the front, 6, 7, 8, swing forward, recover, arms down to the side. Okay, let's go from just that section.
I'm still missing you, boy. I'm tired of missing you, boy. I'm tired of missing you, so please, mister. Don't go missing my boy. Please, mister. Don't go missing no more. I'm tired of missing you, boy. I'm tired.
Because it's the only thing that really goes on both sides, so that we can have balance, yeah? So you're going to do the curl down section with the planks, yeah? Curl down, release, plank, squat, up, rise and lower. From there, we're going to go into the side bend section again, and then we're going to go into the section with the monkey and the flat backs. Okay, I'll cue you as we do it. So let's go from the very beginning.
And I'll go back to the days of December.
Next time, stop and let's go to the beat. Is now 2 counts. So we're moving through the positions quicker, yeah? So the rule is whenever you're moving faster, you need to relax the body more so that you can give into the movement instead of the opposite and tensing. So for this one, I'm gonna face sideways on so that you can see it from that view, but we're gonna go with everything cutting off. Okay, let's give it a go.
And I'll go back to the days of December.
Spinal warm-up. Join me for my next bit.